Marshall Mix Design. Marshall Mix Design. It is used to find optimum bitumen content, in the bituminous mixes. Various parameters can be defined by using phase diagram. Here various components of mix are, suppose let us take, this is make specimen. Specimen means more, it contains various components, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, all those things. Here this is coarse aggregate one, first one, then coarse aggregate two, then fine aggregate, then filler material, some stone dust kind of material, filler, then bitumen, then remaining is air. These are the components involved in bituminous mix. Now this total, this side will write weights, left side, and right side will use volumes. Here the weight of coarse aggregate 1 is, let us take W1. Weight of coarse aggregate 2 is W2. Weight of fine aggregate is W3. Weight of filler is W4. Bitumen weight, let us take, this is WB. Air weight is, you can take it as 0. So total weight is, now weight of the mix, this total weight is weight of mix. Now right side will have volumes, that is this is V1, coarse aggregate volume is V1. Coarse aggregate 2 volume is V2. Fine aggregate volume is V3. Filler volume is V4. Bitumen volume is V suffix B. Air volume is VA. These are the volumes. Now total volume is VM, volume of the mix. This is total volume, is volume of mix. Now we define the parameters. First one, theoretical specific gravity of mix. Theoretical specific gravity. Specific gravity of mix. That is GT. So here GT equal to total weight by, total weight means W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4 plus WB divided by volume excluding air. Volume excluding air, that is V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4 plus VB only. We should not take air. Then this is a theoretical specific gravity. That means this is equal to weight of the mix divided by total volume of the mix minus volume of air, that is GT. Then second parameter is bulk specific gravity of mix. Bulk specific gravity of mix. That is GM. GM equal to total weight of the mix divided by total volume of the mix. That is GM. So first parameter is theoretical specific gravity GT. Second parameter is bulk specific gravity GM. Now, how to find air voids? Air voids. Percentage air voids. Percentage air voids. That is small VA. Here small VA equal to percentage air voids equal to volume of air voids divided by total volume of mix into 100 in percentage. That is equal to VB can be written as, sorry, VA can be, volume of air can be written as volume of mix minus VA divided by VM into 100, which is equal to 1 minus VM can be written as WM by GM. WM by GM minus VM minus VA. So VA can be written as otherwise we know here Vm minus Va we know directly. Vm minus Va is from equation number, from theoretical specific gravity, Vm minus Va is Wm by Gt. Wm by Gt divided by Vm is Wm by Gm. Wm by Gm. So from this we can write Wm, Wm gets cancelled. So here Gt minus 1 minus Gm by Gt. Of course into 100. Or 1 minus Gm by Gt into 100 or Gt minus Gm by Gt into 100. This is percentage air voids. This is percentage air voids. Then next parameter is percentage volume of bitumen, small vb. Percent volume of bitumen, small vb. Here vb equal to volume of bitumen divided by volume of mix, which can be written as, volume of bitumen can be written as weight of bitumen divided by specific gravity of bitumen divided by weight of mix divided by specific gravity of mix, which can be, of course, into 100 is the percentage. Percentage means into 100. That equal to weight of bitumen by specific gravity of bitumen divided by weight of mix divided by specific gravity of mix into 100, which is equal to weight of bitumen divided by weight of mix into 100 into Gm by Gb. Gm by Gb, that equal to percentage of bitumen by weight multiplied by Gm by Gb, that is percentage volume of bitumen Vb. Now voids in, next parameter is voids in mental aggregate Vma. Voids in mineral aggregate Vma. Vma is defined as, Vma is nothing but percentage air voids plus percentage of bitumen, together is called Vma. Next parameter is voids filled with bitumen VFB. Voids filled with bitumen VFB. So VFB equal to, it is defined as small VB divided by VMA, that is VA plus VB. VA plus VB, that is voids filled with bitumen. In percent means into 100. In percent. okay, in percent. This is VFB. Then after knowing all these parameters, we can draw the graphs for various parameters. First parameter is stability versus bitumen. Stability versus bitumen content. Stability is defined as stability means stability measures the maximum load supported by the test specimen at a loading rate of fifty point eight mm per minute. Load is applied to the specimen till failure and the maximum load is designated as stability. Now if you draw the graph for stability versus percentage bitumen, it is like this. Stability versus bitumen. Stability versus bitumen percentage. It is like this. It increases first, then it decreases. At particular bitumen percentage, stability is maximum. At particular bitumen percentage, stability is maximum. That we will note it down as x1 percent. Now second parameter is flow value. Flow value versus bitumen content. Flow value versus bitumen content. Flow is defined as like this. During the loading, the specimen deforms. The flow is nothing but deformation. flow is defined as deformation in 0.25 mm units at failure. The variation of this flow value with bituminous content is as follows. So, flow versus bitumen percentage is like this. It's continuously increasing like this. As bitumen content increases, the flow value keep on increases. The graph looks like this flow value. Then third parameter is unit weight. Unit weight versus bitumen content. It is graph looks like this. Unit weight. Unit weight versus bitumen percent. Unit weight, it increases first, then it decreases again. That means as bitumen content increases, initially its weight increases because it compacts very well. After that, the volume occupies more by bitumen. That's why as bitumen unit weight is less, the unit weight of the mix will again get reduced. So at particular bitumen content, we will get maximum unit weight, that we represent it as x2. At x2, maximum unit weight we can achieve, that is x2. Then fourth parameter is percentage error weights versus VA versus bitumen content. This graph looks like this. VA versus bitumen content in percent. As bitumen increases, air voids continuously decreases. So at 4% air voids, we'll note the bitumen content, which is x3. And one more graph is there. That is fifth one, VFB versus bitumen content. This graph looks like this. This graph is like this. So finally, optimum bitumen content equal to optimum bitumen content equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3.